So, over the last while, I've been accumulating various electronic bits and pieces. One of the most recent ones is this string of RGB LEDs. So, I've been tinkering around with an Arduino and thrown together some MOSFETs and resistors and stuff, and come up with this nice slow fading thing that drives it. Originally, this strip of LEDs came with a cheap driver, and I didn't really like it at all. I wasn't never planning on using it anyway. I always wanted to do it this way, because then I can set the pattern to whatever I want. So I've come up with this slow fade. It's basically just the demonstration fade script, and then duplicated twice, and each of the three colors starting at a different point. One of them starts at 0, one of them starts at 255, and one of them starts about halfway in between. And they just slowly fade up and down independently of each other and create this. So I've decided to turn this, as cool as it is, decided to turn this into a Christmas decoration. So that's what this video is going to be about. Now, there's really ancient chunk of perf board. I don't know how long I've had it. Bought it at Radio Shack back when Canada actually had Radio Shacks. Been cutting bits and pieces off of various projects, and a couple of the pieces are little squares like that, which I'm going to be using to sort of as a center hub for the LEDs. Now I'm just marking out where I'm going to, how much room I'm going to need for the Arduino, and some header pins to connect the LEDs to. Get some power in, and then room over here for the three MOSFETs and the resistors that are on it. Or go with it. They're basically just what are they? They're pull down resistors just to keep the gates off until I tell them otherwise. I think they're what 15K or something like that. Just whatever. It's not critical precisely what they are. First order of business: cut down a couple of pieces of female header to mount the Arduino on, then trim down the couple of pieces of perf board that I'm gonna need. Okay, here's that piece of perf board cut down. I've got the nano plugged into a couple of slices of header. Initially, just to hold everything in place, I'm going to solder the two ground pins of the nano together with a little piece of wire. And then just leave it dangling off that direction because I'm going to need it later. And then I'll put the power plug on and just carry on here. just lay out how I want my my wiring to go, counting pin spacings for the MOSFETs. And these aren't actual circuit board traces, obviously, it's just a Sharpie, but it's helping me to lay out how I'm going to run the gate wires to the MOSFETs. Then I'll start forming those wires and soldering them down as I go. See what the three MOSFETs in on the left hand side there, and just tacking the wires in. All these wires are just single strands out of a telephone cable or Cat 5 or whatever I had laying around. It's like 22 or 24 gauge. Kept the insulation on just so that I wouldn't have to worry about shorts, even though I got everything laid out. And now, form up the resistors and drop them in. These, like I mentioned earlier, are pull-down resistors between the gate and the ground, just to keep the MOSFETs fully off when I don't intend them to be on. They're 15K, so when the Arduino goes high, it's not stealing any current from the Arduino pins. And I could use any huge resistor I wanted, just happen to have those handy. But just drop those in, bend them, fold them over, and solder them down too. And next is the two sets of pin header, male headers in this case, for my outputs. Bit of masking tape just to hold them in place so they don't go anywhere, and then start soldering from the MOSFETs down to those. And now there's the first of the three, just using a little probe to hold it in place while I get them nice and tight. There's four pins on there, one for each of the colors, red, green, and blue, and one for the common. I'm just soldering the common down now. It's coming across from the power input connector on the right-hand side. You must have got the positive and minus marked with black and red tape, just so I don't have to think and try and remember it. That should be the last solder joint on there. Quick inspection just to make sure I haven't done anything really stupid. And there it is. Okay, moment of truth here. I got the board all finished. Put a little bit of hot melt on just to hold the headers in place. I've taken the Arduino, the Nano off that I was using on there. That one was a dead one. I was just using it as a spacer, and I didn't care if I killed it from overheating it because it's already dead. So, time to take the Nano that I've been running my strip on all day and pop that out of there and into here. Power this up from the same power supply. And hope for the best. So far, so good. It draws a moderate amount of current, but not enough to worry about. That's a good start. Next, transfer the strip over. It's set to 12 volts, half an amp for current limiting for now, on. And that is a result. Okay, that part's all neated up and family friendly. Now all I have to do is build the actual displays. Now that I've got the controls done, it's time to cut up the LED strip into the various pieces that I need. So I need some 4 short pieces, 2 medium pieces, and 2 long pieces. And then these strips have they're weatherproof strips. I'm not using them outdoor, but they're weatherproof anyway, just what I happened to buy. So I have to cut the weatherproof rubbery silicone-y kind of coating off at the connection points so that I can solder onto them. This is kind of an annoying process. It's really stuck down and it's very flexible. It grabs onto the knife. Eventually, once I get it pried up a little bit, I can use cutters to snip it off. And there we go, bare copper to solder onto. And after those are all done, tin the ends. Make sure that I've got all the rubbery crud off there so that it'll actually take solder. And continue. So I decided when I was doing the measurements that the pieces of strip were going to be either 2 LEDs for the short ones, 4 LEDs for the medium ones, and 6 LEDs for the long ones. And got those all soldered up. The next thing, the little square of circuit board, of perf board that I cut off earlier, I'm taking some of my solid, was it 22 or 24 gauge wire, stripped it off, and I'm just stitching it through there to create basically 4 concentric rings of wire that I can use as bus bar or a circuit board. And here I've got them all laid out. This is the back side of it. I'm just tack soldering the corners where the two ends of the same wire meet. But there, okay, so here's the other side. You can see the 4 concentric rings, and I'm starting to solder just short lengths of wire on. These are the wires that are eventually going to go out to the LED strips. I just pre-soldering them on here. I found it was a little bit easier than to solder it before the LEDs were tied on. And the first 4, the top, bottom, left and right sides were fairly straightforward to get on. Now getting the diagonal ones on there for my 4 shortest LED strips is a little tight, a little fiddly, but I managed to get them all on. Just took my time, one wire at a time, solder it on, wrap some masking tape around some of the bundles just to keep them together and out of the way of the next ones. So now that that's done, and I've got 8 bundles of wire coming off, it's time to solder the wires onto the LED strips. You notice that I've chosen 4 separate colors. I've chosen black for the common, blue wire for the blue, and a red and a green wire for the red and green. And yay, the first one works. Nice. So carry on to the second one, and as I go, I'm just, once I got it soldered, I'm just putting a bit of heat, hot melt glue on, just to give it some rigidity, and then carry on. And after a while, fairly fiddly soldering, got all 8 of them on, and there it is, a star. Still more to do though. About to give it a quick test. And my test is just a 9-volt battery that I'm clipping on. These strips are rated at 12 volts, but 9 volts is enough to get them to light up. And there we go. Now the last soldering of the project is to solder on the wire that goes out. After that, cut a piece of plastic. This is fairly stiff plastic. It's actually desk protector plastic or desk pad protector plastic from Staples, $5 a chunk. And that is just going to give me something to attach the LED strips to, make it nice and rigid, and allow me to hang it in the window without any problems. So just measure twice, measure three times, make sure it's all nice and straight, peel the backing off, and stick it down. And it's important to measure carefully before you put it down, because it's a real pain to pull up if you missed. But there we go. And through the magic of editing, there's all the pieces stuck down. Very nice. And now, because I forgot to record the next part, here's what it looks like installed. Merry Christmas.